minus 15 seconds, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5 seconds.
So, vehicle, GSLV vehicle, inclination of two boosters has to get successfully lifted off from the second launch pad. So GSLV Mk III going through the dense atmospheric phase of flight, which is very critical for the launch vehicle. And we just heard from the range operation director the performance of the S-200 solid strap-on booster is normal.
Just 1 minute.
We are 60 seconds into the flight. Vehicle has climbed to an altitude of almost 15 kilometers. And as for the flight sequence, at 110 seconds, we should have the ignition of L110, which will be followed by the separation of two solid strap-on boosters at 140 seconds. So right now we are at 86 seconds now. The altitude is around 27 kilometers and velocity is just 1 kilometer per second. And on the display plot, we have a very close match of the vehicle altitude, the pre-flight and the flight predictions.
जी हाँ जी, क्योंकि आसमान बिल्कुल साफ है इसलिए दूर तक अंतरिक्ष में जाता हुआ जीएसएलवी मार्क 3, और जैसा कि हम देख पा रहे हैं L110 इग्निशन सफलतापूर्वक शुरू हो चुका है. लिक्विड इंजन लिक्विड स्टेज और जो सॉलिड स्टेज थी, जो ठोस चरण था, उसका निष्पादन बहुत सफलतापूर्वक समाप्त हो गया.
So L110 has been ignited at 112 seconds as far as the pre-flight program. So right now we are at 135 seconds, so we have continuous burning of strap-ons and L110. And just now we saw the announcement that two solid strap-on boosters S-200 has been successfully
अलगाव हो चुका है मुख्यान से और केवल अब द्रव चरण और क्रायोजेनिक इंजन यान उपग्रह को लेके अंतरिक्ष में अपने पथ पर अग्रसर.
So you can see on your screen the vehicle with L110C25 going into the towards the orbit and the two strap-ons which are falling apart after its burn out at 140 seconds, re-entering. This is the view of the solid strap-on boosters separation from the main vehicle. We are at 185 seconds into the flight, altitude of almost 100 kilometers. The next flight event we are looking at is at 230 seconds when we'll have the separation of the payload fairing, which is the one which protects the spacecraft during the atmospheric phase. And on your screen the parameters, the altitude which indicates the height at which the launch vehicle is presently going through from the earth, and the relative velocity of the launcher. So closed loop guidance algorithm has been initiated at 149 seconds.
Yeah,
performance of LN10 is normal.
जो अगला क्षण है वो महत्वपूर्ण है, पेलोड फेयरिंग सेपरेशन में सुरक्षा कर, और वो भी सफलतापूर्वक अलग हो गया है. और इसके साथ ही 230.8 सेकंड पे इसके अलग हो जाने के बाद अब उपग्रह अंतरिक्ष में सीधे एटमॉस्फेयर पे खुला हुआ और इस तरह से अपने पथ पर अग्रसर. लिक्विड इंजन का प्रज्वलन जारी है, जो करीब करीब या प्रक्षेपण प्रज्वलन शुरू होने के बाद से लगभग 315 सेकंड तक जलता रहता है. इस समय हम करीब करीब 4 मिनट 24 सेकंड का समय बीत चुका है और हमें 5 मिनट 15.72 सेकंड पे इसे L110 को शट ऑफ करेंगे, बंद करेंगे.
So just now you saw on your screen the successful separation of the payload fairing at 230 seconds. The flight is now 282, with the velocity of almost 3.4 kilometer, and the range is the distance which the launcher has traveled from the launch base, is nearly 450 kilometers now, and vehicle is at an altitude of 145 kilometers.
Just 5 minutes.
So as per the nominal flight sequence, we should have the LN10 separation at 318 seconds. And we are seeing on our screen the ignition command authorization has been given for the C-25 stage, which generally happens 20 seconds before its actual ignition. This authorizes LN10 stage has been shut off successfully, and LN10 stage has been separated. C-25 ignition has been confirmed. The cryogenic stage, the C-25 stage, has successfully ignited at 324.7 seconds. This is one of the very major event that will happen during this flight, the successful ignition of the C-25 stage. As I indicated earlier, the burn time for the C-25 stage will be almost for 680 to 700 seconds. So we are at 350 seconds now. The vehicle has reached altitude of almost 176. As per the sequence, the cryogenic stage should shut off at 1000 seconds, which should be another 600 seconds to go. And 15 seconds after the shutoff of the C-25 stage, we will have separation of GSAT-29.